Blackstone Audio presents Many a Twist, a County Cork Mystery by Sheila Connolly. This book is read by Amy Rubinate. Isamoy Cor Saseo. There is many a twist in life. 1.
What do you think? Gillian Callanan asked nervously. It's not been easy for me to do much lately. What with the baby coming. And Harry's been so busy trying to sort out clients that he hasn't been around as often as I'd like. He'd like to be, I think.
Maura Donovan looked at her obviously pregnant friend and wondered whether it was the very unfinished home or the impending birth of her and Harry's child that had made her so frazzled. Probably both, Maura guessed. Not that she had any real experience with either pregnancy or home decoration. But Gillian had asked for her opinion, and she wasn't going to weasel out of answering it.
I think it's a great place. It's got the right amount of space for the three of you, and the view of Ballinloch is terrific. It's all on one floor. It's close to where you'll be working.
Gillian interrupted with a snort.
If ever I work again, we still haven't touched the studio space, and it's filthy.
We'll round up a bunch of the regulars from Sullivan's and scrub the place down for you. I'll offer them some free pints. Location, great. Size, perfect. Access, easy. You've got a decent road right in front, but it'll be quiet, because whatever cars go by, the studio in front will block the noise.
If I ignore the fishermen swarming about 6 months out of the year.
I thought fishing was quiet.
Once you're out on the lake, it is. But it's the getting there that's noisy. And once the men are done for the day, they've been known to lift a few bottles on the way in.
Is that legal?
Gillian shrugged.
Live and let live, we say. But this place has been empty for so long that those who fish here often have forgotten that it's a home.
Maybe I can ask Sean Murphy to keep an eye on things.
Your faithful Garda. What is he these days, friend? Or more than friend?
I don't know, Maura muttered, but I'm sure he'd help.
Don't trouble yourself. Harry and I will work things out. Harry can always offer them his services as an accountant, which might hurry up their exit.
Is he having any luck? Maura asked, feeling a bit anxious.
Harry Townsend had been a modestly successful accountant in Dublin, but then his great-aunt Aveleen, who'd lived in the local manor house near Maura's pub, had passed away not long ago, and Gillian had turned up pregnant. Gillian and Harry had been on again, off again for years, but now they seemed to be firmly on, and Aveline's passing had provided just enough funds to buy the decrepit house and former creamery overlooking a small lake, Ballinloch. Harry had given up his apartment in Dublin and was trying to make a go of his business locally, but he'd been struggling. Maura knew, in theory, that a lot could be done by computer these days, but she had no idea what the timeline might be for setting himself up and finding clients in West Cork. The baby, on the other hand, had a very definite timeline. And no matter how Maura tried to reassure Gillian, the house was still just short of livable. Being so close to the water, there were damp problems, and little maintenance had been done for at least the past 10 years. Maura really was going to have to step up her game, corral some of her patrons, and make sure the essential things got done on time.
Okay, Gillian, tell me this. What absolutely, positively has to be done before the baby comes?
Gillian gave some thought to the question before answering.
I've little experience with infants, but I'm going to guess the child should be warm and dry, so at least his or her room should be finished and done right. You know, heating, double-pane windows, proper ventilation. And I'm told they soil their clothes every time you turn around, so there'd best be a washer and a place to dry clothes. Something like a basic kitchen so I can keep Harry and myself fed without too much work. A place to sit and somewhere to sleep. God help us, there's next to no furniture. I've been living in rented flats in Dublin for years with none of my own. Harry's been promised a few bits and pieces from the manor house, but I'd feel terrible watching black mold creeping up 18th century end tables. You're lucky up the hill there. You get more of a breeze.
Has your family come around yet?
Do you mean, have they forgiven me? Or have they actually visited here?
Either one.
Does anyone on your side have any baby things they can recycle?
I doubt it, Jillian told her, looking resigned. My ma's still not speaking to me, and my sisters resent me because I'm the one who got away, took myself off to Dublin, and called myself an artist, while they were stuck here having babies and going to mass with ma. You'd think they'd be eager to come lord it over me now, wouldn't you?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.